प्लीज करियर सर, ऑल द बेस्ट सर.
यस सर, थैंक यू शर्मा जी.
थैंक यू सर.
गुड मॉर्निंग व्यूअर्स, वी आर येट अगेन अप विद अ न्यू सेशन, इंटरेस्टिंग सेशन विद लॉट ऑफ नॉलेज, लॉट ऑफ एक्सपीरियंस विच कैन ओनली हेल्प अस टू ग्रो. And as we have heard from many sources, learning should never end. So it's another opportunity for us to learn something new. And we must be grateful to Sports Authority of India and Table Tennis Federation of India for bringing such an innovative initiative during this time of lockdown. Difficult times, I know all of us are all very keen to get back to your normal working. But yes, we are also sportsmen and we are disciplined. So we have to follow the government advisories which are for our benefit. So till the government advises you, it is a request that all of you will stay home, stay safe. And use this time productively in developing your new skill and developing your old skill better. And this is one of the platforms that we are going to use. So today, our speaker is going to be one of the very senior most person involved in table tennis for more than 6 decades in various capacities as coach, as player, coach, administrator, and also commentator. He is currently based in Hyderabad, but he started his career in Punjab, and he has been connected with so many Indian camps that if I list out, it is going to take a lot of time. And he is still passionately and full-fledgedly involves himself with any table tennis activity and any table tennis player. He was the coach when I was a player and very humble, always very cooperative and very helpful. So we have Mr. V.R. Mukamala. Mr. Mukamala, thank you very much for giving your valuable time and now go to share your knowledge and experience with all the participants. I'm sure it will be great insight to them. And they will use it to make themselves better and also impart better coaching to their students and making more and more champions for India and thus making India a bigger powerhouse in table tennis. With these few words, simple instructions to all, as we are all sportsperson, please in certain kind of decorum. We have with us our evaluator, Manju Shridayanand, and she will be evaluating you people. So when you're sitting with the video on, ensure that you are serious and focused, because these are all subjects you need to focus on to understand. One. Two, if the network is not good at your end, it's requested that you put off the video and be on audio. It helps you because if the bandwidth is not sufficient, and at least you can clearly hear the valuable words. And another thing, every evening there is another sports science session from 5 o'clock, for which the detail we have always put for each and every session, but we'll put it at the end of the session. And one more instruction is that key Sports Authority of India, along with National Testing Agency, which is the government body, is going to conduct test. And you can see on the screen the slide. This test is going to be conducted on 3rd May and 31st of May. 30th May is for each discipline. For us, ours is a table tennis discipline. And it is for Sai coaches, it is mandatory. And for all those who are participants, it is absolutely voluntary. But it is requested and suggested, or even say advised. Please take it. It will only enhance your knowledge. So it's for your benefit. And each participant will be given an e-certificate, which will be valuable whenever they are in any other field, wherever they go for government jobs, etc. And as you know, our sports minister has announced already that coaching sector is going to be focused on, and there's going to be large number of recruitment in each and every discipline to make the coaching platform stronger and the base broader. And lastly, tomorrow is a Sunday, so we will not be having our session, but we will definitely have our session continued from Monday. Same time, the same meeting ID works. With these few words, may I now welcome Mr. Mukamala. It's all over to you, sir.
Thank you. Should I start sharing the screen, sir?
Yeah, please, please.
Yeah, you can start, sir.
No, that is points are required. This is the topic.
Yeah.
This is the topic.
Yeah, okay. Yeah. This is about myself. I joined the Dadan NIS at Jalandhar. I worked there from 1971 to 1978. And during this period, I went to the schools, number of schools, because there was no facilities in the indoor stadium at Jalandhar for table tennis. And except some senior players, there were no new players. So at that time, as a coach, as a newly joined coach, what I wanted is that I must get some trainees and then I can approach the sports department. Till that time, I didn't want to approach the sports department. What I did is, I went to the state association, the old player, the senior player, the late Mr. P.C. Vidya. I have requested him, Mr. Vidya, you give me an old possible table to me. Sir, what do you do? I said, I want this table to take to the school to school. Then he said, okay, I'll give you. Then I took the table by rickshaw to school to school. Some schools, they gave me a good hall. Some schools, they asked me to coach in the veranda. And I didn't bother about all these things. I didn't worry also. I coached in whatever the place they have given, I coach. By the end of the year, I have covered more than about 12 schools. Out of 12 schools, 6 to 8 schools purchased the table tennis tables. With that, I was very happy that the table tennis introduced in these schools. Then coming to the Hansa Stadium, where my coaching center was there, to one table. On the top, Mr. Janail Singh, the famous footballer, was a deputy director at that time for sports department of Punjab. One day he called me, Mr. Mukamala, how can you manage these 100 students on one table? So I'm very happy to call, to collect these people, but to get some place in the indoor stadium. At that time, the indoor stadium was meant for only shuttle badminton. Then they gave me on dais of the indoor stadium. Then I took about 4 tables. From then onwards, I started. Meanwhile, you know, Sardar Balbir Singh, the director of Punjab Sports Department and the short corner specialist in the hockey and Olympian gold medalist, he was the director of Punjab Sports Department. He visited me. He visited my center. Then he asked me, Mr. Mukamala, are you satisfied with this? I said, no, I'm not satisfied, sir. What do you want then? I want a better center, which you can provide. He said, you go to any school, to any office, to find out a hall suitable to you. The same case, Mr. Sardar Milkha Singh, the Flying Sikh of India, he also told me that to such any school, any this thing, I went to the one government senior model school in Jalandhar. I saw a hall, very beautiful hall. It was very well decorated with the chairs and curtains and everything. Then I met the school principal. Principal, I asked him, so what will you do with this hall? Because this is well decorated, it's a good hall. He said, now and then we'll conduct some meetings. Then I requested, sir, shall I request you one thing? He said, okay, go ahead. I want to use this table tennis hall for our table tennis coaching, where our school children also can participate in this coaching. And whenever you require a hall, one day before you tell me, myself, not only me, my students will keep neatly this hall as today's condition. Hello. And then my students have come up. I have produced Indian young players from there in junior. Then coming to the on my request, there one more thing I have to tell you only, that Sardar Balbir Singh and Sardar Milkha Singh, they came. Now you got a good hall. What do you want? I said, sir, balls are very not comfortable. They are not equivalent to the Netaku ball, which in the national they are playing. With these balls, whatever practice they are practicing here, they are not able to play in the nationals. They are not able to cope up with the speed and other things. That's why we want the balls and the selectables. they have provided me, though it is a purely government department, the name of a very good Indian ball, they provided me Nitapu balls. Then from there onwards, I never looked back, and then I got good results from there. Please, my Punjab, first, the names I can tell you, the Dawud Ram is there, Arun Saigal was there, now you are out. Secretary Punjab, Pankaj Sharma, along with them, more other players are there who represented, who were introduced by me in the Punjab, represented. And one more thing I did it. From my coaching center, the players used to play in the nationals. I did not satisfy with that. No, it should be given chance to everybody. That is through competition. Then I went to district. Even you know, the Faridkot, if I'm not wrong, I took the table tennis tables along with the cooperation of the state association. We have conducted a state championship in the nook and corner of Punjab, that is a water park town of Punjab. We have conducted state championship there. With that, by that time I left after 8 years. Every district of Punjab started playing table tennis. Minimum number of 400 to 500, 2,000 players. Registered players were there. Then I have come back to Andhra Pradesh. I was posted on my request to Vijayawada. There also I coached the collector of Krishna district. He has given me good facilities. I have coached there. I have produced number of players there. And there also, I have coached a number of schools to get more and more students to get a competition. For my student, a player should be selected for the state or national or international. It should be on his merit, not on the recommendation of anybody. This is my view, and I work for that. And then, on my request again, I was transferred to Hyderabad. Here, I got a very good say. Earlier, we were conducting coaching in the downstairs of the outdoor stadium. But afterwards, 1989, when I went back from my Indian camp, the pre-Olympic football was they wanted to conduct. Then they have shifted my table to the stable. They closed it, in fact. Then I said, sir, what is this? My center is closed. Mission Basit of the mission MD. He said that, what we will do now, these 3 months you will be busy with this. Sir, I will be busy with that. What about my students? They have to practice. Then they asked me to go and meet the shuttle batting coach. I got a hall there. I placed 5 tables there. There onwards, I got the trainees, same case, new trainees. I got them and I produced. I brought, after 14 years of break, I brought our men team, women team, all other teams in the first grade in the nationals. This was my coaching in the 2 states. Next, education. A player, I always believe in this. Not only me, any player plays 2 nationals in the year. You say, what are the 2 nationals? It is only 1 national. How can you say the 2 nationals? No, sir. The career of a child, it depends upon these 2 national results. That is table tennis and education. I have compared in such a way to my students. I told them, I used to interact with my students every day. I said, this way I have compared them. Your local tournaments with the unit test, you have to prepare for both the things. And your state championship, state ranking tournaments. Also, for the unit test, then state championship, that is the next target, immediate of the state ranking tournaments, immediate target for my students is state championship, to do better, to come in the first 4. And then, with this, you have to go for your half-yearly examination, because that is a testing point. If you complete very good in the half-yearly examination, you will do better in the state championship also. And then, the national championship. They played national championship and accepted another national championship is annual examination. And believe it or not, I asked my students in such a way that you maintain two class books. In the coaching, you write whatever the coach said in that session, and you come back after the session, after 5 minutes. You say, sir, you told this, I played. You told this, a little bit difficult, I played. You told this, with more difficult, but this the other point, I could not get it. Why I asked them to come back after 5 minutes? Because my concentration was always on my 20 students whenever I'm giving coaching to them. At that time, I remember their movements, where they are committing mistakes, all these things I used to tell them, and then I used to ask them to practice the same the evening session before your regular schedule starts. And this way, when the class books they maintain for when 1 week, they should go through for 1 week revision, then they should come back. The same way, 15 days, they revision and come back to the coach. Same way, 1 month, same way, year. With this, same case in the education also. School teacher will help them. The same way, this way. With this, what I told them is, at that time, you require a very little services of a coach for your present condition, corrections. You will be knowing very better way your weak points, your strong points, both education as well as this one. And here, the one important point is to achieve this. I will give one example. How the players have got the good results in the education also. Not a single trainee of mine. They were all in the first state in the state, and they were all, if not dominion, they passed in the above first class. For example, I can give a very good example. Recent player who stopped after joining MBBS, Karuna Spurti. She did a very good performance in both. Very good performance. She represented India. She won US Open Hopes tournament. Apart from that, she was a junior national champion. Apart from that, she has participated in a number of international events, and I believe she was in junior hopes, I think. That is, she was world number 36. That is one nationals. The second is, just believe it or not, she got in the intermediate first year 99.4% in the education, the examinations. And in the second year, again she scored 99.4%. And here, these 2 years she has playing for India, getting good results. How it is possible? It's not possible if you are not planning. It's not possible if you don't mend your class books by seeing that your weak points, your strong points, what you have to do, what you have to do. This is what she did, and she achieved, and she got the very good results in this. One more experience I tell you, if you have only one background, say education, you may be something, you may be good job and everything, but you will be recognized in that field only. But outsiders, others, they will not be recognized you as a sportsman or anything, no. Suppose you are a sportsman, you are a national champion, you are Arjuna Awardee, but you don't have background of the education, not much recognized. Example I will give you, during my Punjab stay in Patiala, at that time the ranking tournament was going on, I was in a manual rickshaw. The rickshaw driver, I asked him, I used to interact with the people, anybody, not only with my trainees, anybody used to interact, I used to share my piece with their piece in the connector subject. I asked him, I saw your hockey racket keeping on your rickshaw. Are you a hockey player? Then he said, my hockey player. मैं हॉकी प्लेयर हूँ. आपने कहाँ तक खेला है? वो बोलता है कि मैं नेशनल्स खेला हूँ सर, मैंने प्री ओलंपिक्स खेला, वो ओलंपिक भी खेला हूँ, लेकिन मेरे पास एजुकेशन है. एजुकेशन एजेंसी की तरफ से नो वन कुड एबल हेल्प देम, वेरी फ्यू विल बी हेल्प गेटिंग हेल्प बट नॉट टोटल. सो दिस वाज वन ऑफ द माई पर्सनल एग्जाम्पल एक्सपीरियंस इन दिस. कमिंग टू द to get all these things, these confidence in both the nationals, what we require is the confidence, concentration, then observation, then coordination, then your action, and lastly yoga. Yoga is also important. Confidence, when you go for any of these things, from the beginning of your day, there is sports or education, you should be very confident. Yes, I am going to play today. As the coach given me this one to play, I will complete. I will play. That is determination. The determination gets them the concentration, the confidence, the concentration. Whatever you do, whatever work you are doing, if you concentrate on that, your mind. If you concentrate on that, you will realize what you have to do. What is that you are doing? What is that you are reading? What is it you are playing? How you are moving? How you are writing? All these things, with the concentration, you will get it. And your observation is a very, very important point for the in both the sections. You have to observe the ball. You have to observe what coach says that. You have to observe what teacher said that in the class. All these things. If you don't observe, you said the ball is coming. You say the ball is coming, you don't know. If you don't observe, what is the, you are not able to study the your education lesson. If you don't observe your teacher's lesson carefully, then coordination comes. You are both here. Here, in table tennis, what is required coordination right from mind to physical body condition. To play a ball, the ball is coming that side. You are observing here. One, you are observing here because of your concentration, and the mind says that you go there. The ball is coming there. You go there. Then, what is as per the body, that is mind instructions. The mind is coordinated with your body. You are going there, and then execution. That execution, that is action. You see. You will play that stroke with confidence because of these coordinations. You play that one very confidently. This is why these five important points for that. To get all these things, yoga. Yoga is very important for the sportsman. When I have interacted with a Ayurvedic doctor on TV5. Then I said that yoga is compulsory for sportsmen also. I asked him. He said yoga is compulsory. I said I used to give my sports people in Indian camps as well as in my regular camps, that is pranayamam and shavasana. Pranayamam is meant for lungs capacity. It is helps you very good to make your lungs power more, which is required for your energetic level, for your not exerting earlier, but to reach before reaching your target. These things definitely will help in the education also. These two things will help. This is what I did in the Indian camps also. I did this one. Pranayama. I saw here our beloved family member, Kamlesh Mehta. Most of the other players, they were not concentrated. That is the shavasana. Pranayama must have done it early in the morning. After losing exercise, I saw our beloved Kamlesh Mehta doing the Shavasana. I will explain to you later on that one. Even then, now also I will explain to you the Shavasana, why we required to do Shavasana. After the your every session is over, we do breathing exercises, you do warming up exercises, that is in the loosening, then passive in the stretching, then we go for the loosening exercises of the taking in oxygen, leaving it. Even then, when your running is also involved in that, slow, fast, and then slow, then walk is also involved in that. And then, lastly, to achieve the Shavasana. Why I am telling these things? Because when you reach the top level performance time, that is, at the end of your session, you are in the peak practice. At that time, your energy level comes down. At that time, a thing will produce, that is, acid will produce, that is, lactic acid. The lactic acid will help to the players to maintain at that level to do this, to produce the same performance. That lactic acid has to be removed. For that, is Shavasana there. Next.
Kamlesh, do you want to translate?
Okay, fine. Can we go to the first slide? Well, in this first slide, मुकामवाला सर ने फर्स्ट स्लाइड इसलिए बताई है, बेसिकली उन्होंने ये बताना जताना चाहते थे कि जब उन्होंने एनआईएस किया और उनकी पहली पोस्टिंग जालंधर में थी तो उस वक्त किस तरह की फैसिलिटीज मिलती थी। मतलब ये था कि उनको टेबल टेनिस कोच के लिए वो वहाँ अपॉइंट हुए थे, लेकिन वहाँ पे कोई ऐसा टेबल टेनिस के लिए स्पेशल कोई जगह नहीं थी जहाँ पे ट्रेनिंग दी जाए। वो यंग थे, वो एंथुजियास्टिस्ट थे, तो उन्होंने अपने आप सोचा कि अगर मुझे टेबल टेनिस को ले जाना है तो मुझे ग्रास रूट लेवल पे ले जाना होगा। तो उन्होंने खुद ही ये डिसाइड किया कि वो स्कूल्स में जाके करेंगे। तो उनके वक्त स्कूल में जाएंगे तो वो टेबल पूरा टेबल टेनिस का टेबल उन्होंने वहाँ के स्टेट सेक्रेटरी से रिक्वेस्ट करके पुराना टेबल उन्होंने उनको मिला और रिक्शा में लेके जाते थे कहीं स्कूल में, और कहीं जो स्कूल में जाते थे सिखाने के लिए तो स्कूल अपनी तरह से अलग अलग फैसिलिटीज देती थी। कोई अच्छा हॉल भी देते थे असेंबली हॉल में, कहीं पैसेज होता है जो वरांडा बोलते हैं उसमें भी उनको रखने को देते थे। तो वो ये कोई फैसिलिटीज की चिंता किए बगैर अपने जी जान से अपने पूरा वो टेबल टेनिस सिखाते थे, मन से सिखाते थे। और उस 8 साल पंजाब में रहे और उसमें बहुत से लोगों से उन्होंने सपोर्ट भी मिला, जैसे कि जर्नल सिंह लेजेंडरी फुटबॉलर, बलबीर सिंह लेजेंडरी हॉकी प्लेयर एंड ओलंपियन मेडलिस्ट, ये सभी लोगों ने उन्होंने बहुत मदद की टाइम टाइम पर। और उन धीरे धीरे उन्होंने स्टेडियम में मूव किया जहाँ पे एक टेबल से 4 टेबल हो गए, 4 टेबल के बाद गवर्नमेंट स्कूल में उन्होंने किया। तो मतलब ये 8 साल में वो बहुत स्कूलों में जाके टेबल टेनिस का ये उन्होंने अपना ज्ञान सिखाया। और ऐसा था कि जब वहां से वो फिर हैदराबाद आए तो पंजाब में टेबल टेनिस अच्छा फैल गया था। दूसरी बात है, तो जब हैदराबाद आया, हैदराबाद में उन्होंने विजयवाड़ा में पहले किया, फिर आंध्र प्रदेश में आए, उसमें पहले विजयवाड़ा में किया और फिर हैदराबाद पे आए और वहाँ पे उन्होंने फुल टाइम कोचिंग स्टेट लेवल नेशनल लेवल प्लेयर्स का शुरू किया था शुरुआत में। और उन्होंने बाद में, नाउ कैन वी गो टू सेकंड स्लाइड, या वो यहाँ के बाद और उनका इतने सालों का एक्सपीरियंस, उन्होंने कहना है कि एक प्लेयर एक नेशनल नहीं खेलता है, 2 नेशनल खेलता है। तो ये सबको पूछेंगे क्यों, तो एक होता है कि जो अपने स्पोर्ट्स, जो आपकी स्पोर्ट्स है यहाँ पे टेबल टेनिस है, और दूसरा है एजुकेशन। ये बहुत इम्पॉर्टेंट पॉइंट है, हर कोच, हर पेरेंट, हर प्लेयर को ये बहुत जरूरी समझना है कि स्पोर्ट्स और एजुकेशन दोनों ही इम्पॉर्टेंट है आपके डेवलपमेंट के लिए। आप ये कहेंगे कि सिर्फ मैं अच्छा टेबल टेनिस प्लेयर बनूं और एजुकेशन नहीं करूं, ये उनका मानना है कि ये सही नहीं, और मेरा भी यही मानना है। स्पोर्ट्स दोनों कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री है, वो एक दूसरे को मदद करती है अपने डेवलप करने के लिए। अगर आप पढ़ाई में अच्छे हो तो आप टेबल टेनिस प्लेयर भी अच्छे बन सकते हो, ये आपको हेल्प करता है, क्योंकि पढ़ाई की जो क्वालिटी होती है वो आपको टेबल टेनिस में जरूर पड़ती है। जब एग्जांपल, अगर आपको पढ़ाई में क्लास में अच्छा करना है तो आपको कंसंट्रेशन करना है, रेगुलर उसको पढ़ाई करनी है, तो आपको फोकस होना चाहिए, आपका ऑब्जर्वेशन होना चाहिए, आपको इंटेलिजेंस होना चाहिए, आपको कोऑर्डिनेशन होना चाहिए। तो ये सारी चीजें टेबल टेनिस में अच्छा करने की आपको मदद करती है। उसी तरह अगर टेबल टेनिस अच्छे है तो टेबल टेनिस में भी ये सारी चीजें होती है क्या, बिना कोई कॉन्सेंट्रेशन, बिना फोकस, बिना कोऑर्डिनेशन, बिना रेगुलर प्रैक्टिस, हार्ड वर्क, आप टेबल टेनिस से अच्छे नहीं बन सकते। ये दोनों के क्वालिटीज इतने कॉमन है कि आप इसे जरूर मैनेज कर सकते हैं, क्योंकि ये दोनों आपको मदद करती है। इसके बारे में मैं सत्यन का एग्जाम्पल भी देना चाहूंगा। सत्यन से बात हो रही थी, सत्यन ने यह कहा कि मैंने टेबल टेनिस और पढ़ाई को मैनेज नहीं किया, मैंने सिर्फ टाइम को मैनेज किया। मतलब ये है कि हमारा मेरा टाइम प्रॉपरली यूज किया ताकि मैं दोनों में अच्छा कर पाए। उसी तरह उनके खुद की एक स्टूडेंट के बारे में बता रहे हैं और उसके पहले कि अगर ये चीज करना है तो एक मिनट, कैन यू गो बैक टू द अर्लियर स्लाइड, सॉरी वन मोर स्लाइड बैक। यहाँ पे ये बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है कि कौन कौन लोग आपको ये दोनों चीज में फोकस करने में आपकी मदद कर सकते हैं। वो एक है पेरेंट्स, ये बहुत बहुत बड़ा पिलर है पेरेंट्स। आप किसी भी खिलाड़ी को पूछिए कि भाई आप ये लेवल पे क्यों पहुंचे तो वो पहले कहेंगे ये मेरे पेरेंट्स की वजह से, और मेरे केस में भी यही बात है। फिर कोच और क्लास टीचर, या तो अपनी स्कूल बोले हम, क्योंकि क्लास टीचर हर साल बदले तो मैं स्कूल बोलूंगा, ये दो इंस्टीट्यूशन बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है। ये पेरेंट्स इज अ फैमिली इंस्टीट्यूशन एंड एजुकेशन इंस्टीट्यूट, और कोच में एजुकेशन इंस्टीट्यूट में गिनता हूँ, इसके लिए मैं दो कहता हूँ। लेकिन वैसे इस पॉइंट में आप ये तीन लोग बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है एक प्लेयर के स्पोर्ट्स कैरियर को आगे बढ़ाने में। नेक्स्ट स्लाइड। और ये सब करने के लिए जैसे मैंने कहा कि ये सारे पॉइंट्स जो है ना, आप टेबल टेनिस खेलते हो तो आपको करने ही पड़ेंगे अच्छा बनने के लिए, और आप पढ़ाई करते हो वहां भी आपको करना पड़ेगा अलग अलग तरीके से, मगर ये करने जरूर पड़ेंगे कि दोनों बहुत कॉमन है दोनों में। और ये जब एक में आप करते हो तो दूसरे में आप ऑटोमेटिक उसका आ जाता है, ये रब्स ऑफ जैसे कहते हैं कि यहाँ का जो अच्छा किया उसके पे कैरी फॉरवर्ड होता है। तो अगर आप 100% अपनी फोकस करके आप प्रैक्टिस करते हो तो आपकी भी कॉन्सेंट्रेशन बढ़ जाती है। उसी तरह आप पढ़ाई भी कॉन्सेंट्रेट करके करते हो, पूरा 100% देते हो, तो जब आप टेबल टेनिस शुरू करते हो वहां भी आपकी बढ़त बहुत जल्दी हो जाती है। नेक्स्ट स्लाइड। और ये एग्जांपल उनका खुद का एग्जांपल था, उन्होंने खुद मैनेज किया है। और ये कर्नम स्कूटी वाज वेरी टैलेंटेड एंड प्लेड वेरी वेल फॉर इंडिया एंड सो मेनी इयर्स इन जूनियर लेवल। ऑफ कोर्स देन शी वेंट इनटू द मेडिसिन, सो शी प्रेफर्ड दैट, बट During her playing time, she did well in both. दोनों में अच्छा किया उसने, पढ़ाई में भी अच्छा किया, और जैसे आपने ये देखा है कि उसको 99.9% तो ये लाने के लिए आसान नहीं, बहुत मुश्किल है। उसके साथ साथ उसने टेबल टेनिस भी बहुत अच्छा किया और बहुत मेडल जीते अपने लिए, अपने परिवार के लिए, अपनी डिस्ट्रिक्ट, स्टेट और देश के लिए। तो ये एग्जाम्पल उन्होंने कहा है कि ये सारा कुछ आप कर सकते हो। और कोई भी प्लेयर को ये जरूरी समझना है कि आप सिर्फ अच्छे खिलाड़ी बने, एजुकेशन में भी उतना ही अच्छा बनना जरूरी है, क्योंकि वो आपको खिलाड़ी अच्छे बेटर खिलाड़ी बनने में जरूर मददगार होंगे। थैंक यू। यस मिस्टर मुकामला।
या थैंक यू। देन कमिंग टू द वन मोर पॉइंट ऑफ फोकसिंग, एज मिस्टर कमलेश्वर सेड दैट बताया उन्होंने कि पेरेंट्स कोच एंड टीचर्स का जो ना कोऑर्डिनेशन जरूरी है। मेरा एक एक्सपीरियंस बता देता हूं मैं, जैसा कोच स्टूडेंट्स बोलता था मिलो बात करने के लिए, टॉकिंग अबाउट देयर वीक पॉइंट्स एंड स्ट्रॉन्ग पॉइंट्स, और इवन इन द टूर्नामेंट्स आल्सो इन द इवनिंग वी यूज्ड टू सिट एंड देन टीचर, आई यूज्ड टू गो टू द टीचर्स देन आई यूज्ड टू टेल देम सर दिस बॉय, ये बच्चा आपके पास पढ़ता है आपके क्लास में, ये इसके तरफ से एक कैंप में गया था या टूर्नामेंट में गया था, इसके लिए ये क्लासेस मिस किया है, लेकिन उसको जो है आपको अपडेट कर दीजिए। लेकिन तब बताना है इसको कि जब वो बच्चा आपको आके पूछता है तभी उसको बताना है। और मैं बच्चों को बताता था कि तुम टीचर से डरना नहीं, जैसा मुझसे नहीं डरते ना कि मैं क्या बोलता हूँ, मुझसे पूछो, क्योंकि एक मैं इतना हैप्पी फील करता हूँ कि एक लड़का मेरा ट्रेनिंग फॉलो कर रहा है कि इज आस्किंग अबाउट दिस थिंग, इज फॉलोइंग माई ट्रेनिंग वेरी सिंसियरली, तो वो भी ऐसे कर रहा है। इस बात से ये तीनों का कोऑर्डिनेशन बहुत जरूरी है। देन कमिंग टू द नेक्स्ट स्लाइड प्लीज, दिस इज पीरियडाइजेशन। जैसा मैं कर्णा स्फूर्ति का बताइए देती है, वो एजुकेशन में MBBS में ज्वाइन होके अब डॉक्टर बन गए, MBBS में ज्वाइन होने के पहले वो अपने टेबल टेनिस को छोड़ दी है बिकॉज ऑफ आर लैक ऑफ टाइम स्पेंडिंग फ्रॉम द MBBS, बिकॉज मे बी प्रैक्टिकल्स आर एनी थिंग सो मेनी। देन नाउ कमिंग टू द पीरियडाइजेशन, अभी जितना अभी तक जो हमने बात किया है कि ये हम अचीव किया, ये भी अचीव किया, ये अचीव किया, उस सब के लिए हमको एक प्लान होना चाहिए। मैं ऐसा करना है, ये ऐसा करना है, व्हाट इज द रिक्वायर्ड इन टेबल टेनिस, कौन सा चाहिए हम टेबल टेनिस के लिए, एजुकेशन के लिए क्या चाहिए हमको, टेबल टेनिस खेलने के लिए ताकत चाहिए, फिजिकल ताकत चाहिए, वी रिक्वायर फिजिकल फिटनेस इन टेबल टेनिस, हैं, देन व्हाट वी रिक्वायर, स्पीड वी रिक्वायर, देन रिकवरी वी रिक्वायर, ऑल दीज थिंग्स इन अ प्लान वे, एंड वी हैव टू यूज माइंड फॉर द टैक्टिकल गेम। ये सबको जो है हम यहाँ कोऑर्डिनेट कराने के लिए, बॉडी के साथ माइंड के साथ कोऑर्डिनेट करके रिजल्ट आने के लिए ये हम पीरियडाइजेशन शुरू कर देते हैं, ट्रेनिंग शुरू करते हैं। ये बच्चों के लिए बहुत अच्छा है और टाइम बहुत कम लगेगा फॉर द रिजल्ट के लिए, क्योंकि वो परफेक्ट स्टेप्स लेते हैं ये पीरियडाइजेशन में। वो जब बगैर पीरियडाइजेशन में करेंगे, वो पकड़ लिया, ये खेल लिया, ये आई प्लेड दिस, आई डिड दैट, इट विल टेक टाइम। वो आप 6 महीने में करना है जिससे कर सकते हैं, वो आप 6 साल में नहीं कर सकते, क्योंकि उसके ऊपर कॉन्सेंट्रेशन नहीं रहता है, कॉन्फिडेंस नहीं रहता, ऑब्जर्वेशन नहीं रहता, कुछ नहीं रहता, आप करते रहते मनमाने। लेकिन ये हम करना है, ये हम कर रहे हैं, ऐसे ऐसे ये आपको पता, ये प्रेजेंटेशन में वो मेन पॉइंट है। देन कमिंग टू दी पीरियडाइजेशन में 3 है, वन इज सिंगल पीरियडाइजेशन, सेकंड इज डबल पीरियडाइजेशन, थर्ड इज मल्टीपल पीरियडाइजेशन। हम जो है हमारे स्टेट प्लेयर्स को नेशनल लेवल तक के है ना, सिंगल पीरियडाइजेशन समटाइम्स डबल पीरियडाइजेशन हम लेते हैं। हम सिंगल पीरियडाइजेशन के लिए हम उसको ये अभी मैं बाद में बताता हूँ कि वो कभी कभी सिंगल पीरियड में क्या होता है, नेशनल्स हम जो है क्या करते हैं, टारगेट्स देते जाते हैं, अरे ये बच्चा ज्वाइन किया ये कोचिंग में तो अरे तुम ये बच्चे को जीतना है, टारगेट नॉन टारगेट नॉट इन्फिनिटी टारगेट, उसके बाद में अरे तुम ये डिस्ट्रिक्ट टीम में आना है, उसके बाद में तुम ऐसे ये स्टेट टीम में आना है, फर्स्ट स्टेट में आना है, उसके बाद में स्टेट चैंपियन बनना है, हैं, उसके बाद में नेशनल रिकॉर्ड बनाना है, ये सब नॉन टारगेट्स है, क्वार्टर सेमीफाइनल फाइनल। नॉन टारगेट देने से इन केस द बॉय लूजेस यू विल नॉट गेट द कंफ्यूजन नॉर यू विल नॉट लूज कॉन्फिडेंस दैट आई कैनॉट प्ले, आई कैनॉट गेट, नो, व्हेन यू फिक्स द नॉन टारगेट्स इज कॉन्फिडेंस लेवल विल बी मोर, विल बिकम मोर एंड मोर टू अचीव द टारगेट्स। टू अचीव द टारगेट्स दिस इज द annual program we are making it, and in that what happens, double preparation when it will come, when the state championship is over, we will be preparing for the national championship, at that time suddenly maybe any reasons, no abhi kya hua hai, sabhi log olympics ko prepare kar rahe hain, hain jab Tokyo olympics ke liye bahut prepare kar rahe hain, lekin kya ho gaya, corona ka aa gaya, corona ka aane se kya ho gaya, iske liye bhi postponed to 1 year. This because of this, what happens, you have to plan again. But in these plans, at any cost, from the, if your national championship is postponed, say by 1 month or 2 months, whatever it may be, your physical fitness should be maintained at the same level. But mental relaxation should be there. If mental relaxation don't do, then mental tension will create and the boy will get into the fatigue. Later on I will explain about the fatigue. This is the, to avoid this one, the double periodization, these things will do it. And multiple periodization, this is for the international players. Earlier, our players used to play very little number of tournaments, that is Asian Championship, then and now later on that has come Commonwealth, then World Championship, these things they used to play. But now the things have gone up. Every player is getting a good chance to play international events. If they are preparing for international events, if a gap is there international to international event, or national event, international event, then the person will go for the multiple periodization. That also same thing, that your mental tension should be reduced. Then other things should be maintained. These are the three periodizations. Now coming to the annual program, there is annual this one. In that, we have preparatory period 1, preparatory period 2, pre-competition, uncompetition, and the later on is transitional period. हम ये प्लान से करते हैं. ये प्लान में कोच कोच हैज टू गिव लॉट ऑफ कंसंट्रेशन फॉर दिस थिंग्स एंड एक्सप्लेन टू द स्टूडेंट एंड दिस थिंग्स यू शुड बी वेरी केयरफुल बाय इंप्लीमेंटिंग व्हाइल इंप्लीमेंटिंग इट्स ऑल डिपेंड्स अपॉन द प्लेयर टू प्लेयर फिजिकल फिटनेस मेंटल प्रिपेयरनेस इट्स ऑल डिपेंड्स ऑन द प्लेयर टू प्लेयर. Even in the table tennis also, when you go for the coaching, it also depends upon the player to player. So now coming to the preparatory one, हम हमारे transitional period होने के बाद हमारे annual exam finish हो गया, इसके बाद में थोड़ा बहुत relax हो गए, इसके बाद में हम शुरू करना है फिर ये school खुलेगा, इधर table tennis coaching hall खुलेगा. इधर कोच रेडी रहेगा, इधर टीचर रेडी रहेगा. तो हम प्रिपेयर करना है. कैसे प्रिपेयर करना है? प्लान से प्रिपेयर करना है. वो प्लान में प्रिपेरेटरी पीरियड में क्या चाहिए, व्हाट ए प्लेयर रिक्वायर्ड इन प्रिपेरेटरी पीरियड टू प्ले फिजिकल फिटनेस, दैट इज वन इज एंड्यूरेंस. हियर आई एम मेंशनिंग 40% डिपेंड्स अपॉन द टाइम अवेलेबिलिटी एंड प्लेयर अवेलेबिलिटी. And then coach always will be there because he has to do his duty. And more and more, a interested coach, who is dedicated coach, definitely will be there. He'll call the students also by phone or he'll go to home also. But here, 40%. Then comparingly, the tactical game in the endurance. First of all, let me do it in endurance. In endurance, what we'll do? We do physical fitness on the ground. What is that? At 6 o'clock a.m. we call the players. They will come 6 o'clock. They will go for warming up exercises. Then active stretching. What is active stretching? A player सुबह में घर से निकल के आता है, warm up कर लेते, then ready होता है कि और stretching body parts को ज़्यादा flexible करने के लिए. उसको जो है वो कर सकता है active stretching. अपने आप कर सकता है. उसको हम बोलते हैं एक्टिव स्ट्रेचिंग. प्लेयर कम से सीखते हैं, ही विल गो फॉर द वार्मिंग अप एक्सरसाइज, देन ही हैज टू गो फॉर द प्रिपेयर द अदर पार्ट्स ऑफ द बॉडी बाय मसल्स बाय एक्टिव स्ट्रेचिंग. अपने आप कर ही कैन बी डू दैट वन. आफ्टर दिस एक्टिव स्ट्रेचिंग देन ही विल गो फॉर द मेन पॉइंट दैट इज एंड्यूरेंस. एंड्यूरेंस ताकत देता है और आपका ताकत बढ़ाता है. इट विल गिव यू फिजिकल फिटनेस. योर रिक्वायर्ड फिजिकल फिटनेस यू गेट इट फ्रॉम दिस एंड्यूरेंस. हाउ विल यू दैट इज आफ्टर दिस प्रैक्टिस दिस वार्मिंग एक्सरसाइज यू हैव टू गिव 10 टू 12 राउंड्स. हियर आल्सो आई एम टेलिंग यू टोटली डिपेंड्स अपॉन द फिजिकल कंडीशंस ऑफ द प्लेयर. हियर आल्सो आई एम टेलिंग यू टोटली डिपेंड्स अपॉन द फिजिकल कंडीशंस ऑफ द प्लेयर. ए टोटल फिजिकल कंडीशंस को आपका प्लेयर के ऊपर डिपेंड करता है. वो अगर से इतना नहीं कर सकता, टेक्टर नहीं भाग नहीं सकता, आप देंगे और कुछ हो जाएगा, और कुछ हो जाएगा विच यू कैन नॉट कंट्रोल. यू वे नॉट टू नोइंग इट, ए डॉक्टर इज रिक्वायर्ड. सो टू अवॉइड ऑल दिस थिंग्स यू शुड नो हिज फिजिकल कंडीशन, देन यू गिव एज पर दैट. 10 to 12 राउंड वी आर गिविंग इट, देन इन दैट मीडियम फास्ट रन, 10 to 12 रनिंग medium fast run with this. Then coming to the shadow practice. So tactical game please. Go back. Endurance is over. Now the technical work. You are coming to the hall. A इसलिए 35% कितना देखो 35% इन दिस 35% हमारे फिजिकल फिटनेस से थोड़ा कम नहीं है. वी आर गिविंग हियर इम्पोर्टेंस नेक्स्ट दैट इज फ्रॉम 40 to 30 फॉर द टेक्निकल वी आर गिविंग 35% हियर. व्हाट वी हैव टू डू इन दिस इज प्लेयर हैज टेकन रेस्ट.
Mr. Mukamla, you want the next slide?
Shall I?
You want the next slide now?
No, this one I have special
edition. Okay.
This one is no time. Yeah. Technical, you go for the consistency, control on the ball with the different strokes from one place on different part place of the place. First, you are playing one place, one side. Second one side is forehand, like that backhand, like that combination. This is the way for the technical. Then tactical. If here comes, tactical means the third ball attack, second ball attack, it is it. But service is very important. Service both important hai. Aap service cut karte hue, service cut is only the ball, then go ahead with the third ball attack, second ball attack. For the practice purpose. Then coming to the rest and recall. Everybody requires rest wala chahiye. और रिकवरी चाहिए 10% ये एंटायर दिस प्रिपरेटरी वन यू हैव टू डू इट दिस वन मॉर्निंग एंड देन इवनिंग एक्सरसाइज अलोंग विद द स्ट्रोक पैड. नेक्स्ट पेज नेक्स्ट स्लाइड. हियर इन द मॉर्निंग सेशन व्हाट वी गिव द शैडो प्रैक्टिस आफ्टर योर वार्मिंग अप एक्सरसाइज से इफ द टाइम इज गैप इज देयर इन द मॉर्निंग groundwork to in a hall work much gap is there, then you have to give warming exercises. Otherwise you're not much concentrate, there is no time they can come because already the body is warmed up. Here we'll do shadow practice, which is very, very important. With the footwork, it is connected to the footwork as well as with the eye observation of the ball. Eye observation more important and with the footwork and combination of this. Combining of this confidence, concentration, and observation, and all the things required. Then, ball feeling practice. After the shadow practice is over, number of shadow practice is there, but just I may explain that one. Ball feeling practice. Here, ball feeling practice because in terms, if you want to take it suddenly, if they drive or anything, they cannot. The body should be flexible, and they should be free their entire thing with the ball. Also with the movement also. That is, ball feeling practice, forehand to forehand, cross, forehand to backhand. There is an opponent of the your practice part also plays only forehand, only both the playing forehand, down the line forehand, then cross backhand, from forehand to forehand, then down the line on the forehand side to forehand side. All this is the forehand practice partner and he's also, he's there. Out of backhand, backhand, these are the ball feeling practices. Then coming to the service practice, you can go ahead with the service practice. Some people see we have number of people are there. You may not be concentrating on them much. So then we divide. Some people will go for the ball by stroke practices. With the movement or without movement, that as I already told you, that for consistency in periodization, consistency in the PP2, for the, with the movement, with PP3 is the tactical. PP2 at the end we'll go at the tactical. PP3 preparatory, we'll go with the strategy, with the movement, with the speed work at the end of the PP2 and pre condition, the speed work in the other table by reducing the number of rallies in say time. Say in one time in PP1 you get 30 rallies. You say 40 rallies, 30 rallies. Then in the PP2, you say that these 40 rallies, you have got control on this, you count, will count the time. Yes, in this, if you play how many rallies you can. That means you are increasing the speed. You are increasing the speed in the time. And then same thing with the movement practices. Here, sequence practices comes. Sequence practices. One sequence, you say that forehand, backhand, the sideways movement, there is one sequence like that. Then backhand, turn forehand, then cross movement with forehand. That's like that. These are the sequences with the stroke practices. Number of stroke sequences are there. You have to give the sequence practices for the movement, correct movement for correct footwork and for all these coordination of the required for body for to reach the ball. Then coming to the service, you say that one XL will become or XL will become next become. Isn't it? You take number of balls. You serve one service. Get control on that. Get confident that you say I can do. Maybe short service, maybe long service, maybe any short service on inside. Maybe on forehand side. Most important thing on forehand side nowadays. So these things, number of services, you have to practice different kinds of short or long or down the line or cross or body line. Then coming to the multi-ball practice, very, very important for multi-ball practice. Of course, some coaches may feel multi-ball robo is compulsory basis, but some coaches, they feel by themselves, as a coach by themselves, thinking that the ball is released from the human hand. That is the mechanical side, the robo practice. Nowadays, robo is also maintaining the different speeds. Earlier, it was not maintaining. Mr. Kamlesh will be knowing it. In 75 World Championship, the robo was placed at NIS for the Indian camps. We saw there is no difference. System is there for the speed maintenance with the different speeds. So here, with the what we give is in the PP1, we give an understanding practice. Chess, I'm playing there. You play this number of times. I'm playing there. You play this number of times. Maybe backhand, maybe forehand. Number of times with the movement from the stance, he has to move. With the stance, he has to move and he has to play. Number of times, number of strokes. These things to perfect with this. Then coming to the at the end of the that is a PP2. Coming to PP2, here the coach they should take. Should be importance on the movement with the anticipatory practice. Anticipatory is very important because should the ball will not tell you when your opponent is playing, ball will not tell you that he is playing there, he is playing this. No, though you are watching, but there will be such a stroke will be there. It will be disappointing you. You may not be able to observe that one. So such strokes, but to cope up with that, with the hand movement, opponent's hand movement, release of the ball till crosses the head, till it comes to you. To cope up that, it is the shadow practice with the ball is very, very important. With the anticipatory practice, very, very important. Some service opening, then playing the drive, even service opening also with the anticipatory. Nowadays the banana. Play. The LRS people, they started this one much. And then forehand click. All these things you can practice during the service practice in the PP2. And then the movement, your the anticipation practice in the service also you have to do with the anticipation also. These are very, very important. And here, PP2, we are going to introduce another sequence practice. That is for the improving that speed of the player on the table. Say, I will tell you three practices. Can I take time?
Yeah, please.
Okay. Three practices are there. That is.
How many sides are there?
Visually can tell you.
Seven more.
Yeah, so you'll have to be little speed up.
Because it is give me a good impression. Mentally, it is a motivation to remember my old things, sweet memories. Shall I go ahead now?
Yeah, please.
Not only on the ground.
Can be a little quicker.
Little quicker.
Concise.
Not only on the ground, for the speed work. In the speed endurance in this, that is we say internal training. That is, we will do it in such a way, as usual, warming up and then your active this one stretching. Then we do here, that is 50 meters slow running, medium fast running, the 100 meters fast running of 2 to 3. It all depends upon the physical fitness of the player. 2 to 3 or 4 rounds of the 400 track. Then next is 30 meters. In 30 meters, is going to 30 meters may for quick recovery. quick recovery, don't touch combat with the footwork. That is, when you are standing in the beginning stage, you are jumping with the legs, making your movement and ready for with the to start to go to very fast with the to touch the end of the ball, 30 meters line. Here 30 meters. In that 30 meters, you have to combine with this. That is, 20 meters, then 30 meters, then 20 meters, then 30 meters. This gives you a quick recovery in short distance in the 30 meters, 20 meters. Later on, we come to the 10 meters. It will give very, very quick recovery. Will give you in 10 meters less than these two. The player will go and touch it and come back. Player will go and touch it and come back. And same thing here for footwork will give you sideways running with the one side, sometimes with the right hand moving first, then with the left hand second, right leg move, then left leg later on, like that from that side, left leg first, then right leg first, like the sideways movement with the, for the perfection of the footwork to help in the shadow practice also, and waist level practices, waist movement, but to strengthen this for free movement practices. All these things are involved in the PP2 also. So, in PP2, your speed and training, I already told you speed training, then technical 40%, then here consistency practice also will be there, it will be less. Then I told you about the stroke practices, that is with the movement, that is forehand, backhand, 3-3-4-4 back, forehand, 3-3-3-4-4 backhand, like that. Then another sequence, backhand, 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 then turn, forehand, forehand, then move cross, forehand, forehand, like that 4 to 5 times each stroke. Then how to improve the speed with these things. Like many strokes are there, like this, many stroke these things are there. Then we will be reducing the number of strokes so that the player will be improving the speed to receive the ball coming from the quick recovery. And then one more this thing is a practice, that is backhand to backhand, then playing one forehand, forehand drive, close to table on forehand and away from the table on forehand, and then the same case with the practice partner also. Then here, the same practice, what we will do is counter this, the same thing without stopping the rallies, they'll play. Here, by reducing the rallies, we'll go ahead with the single also. That is, counter drives. You play backhand to backhand, you play forehand and the, your practice partner forehand. Your practice partner also plays forehand, right? And here from close block, then next you go for the backhand forehand, right? Likewise, different types of thinking practices for the movement. Forward, back, parallel movement, back, forward, backward movement, and cross movements. And then that will give, here it is there, service, third ball attack, service, second ball, there is second ball attack. Then here, when you go for the isolated practice, after multi-ball practice, what you are doing, then go on the table with your practice partner also. Playing first knowing, that is, you play knowingly, playing this side with the player. And then you say that, now we are going for the with the anticipated practice. Players play anywhere on the table, but they have to go and play by reaching correct time, it's quick recovery, they have to play. These are the very important practices for the anticipatory in the preparatory period to develop their anticipation, quick recovery, and the speed work. And in the PP2 end, in the tactical only, what we do, a coach has to give a lot of concentration to develop the confidence level, that's psychological. That is, I used to do, I think Mr. Kamlesh, we may be knowing, Krishna Kirti game. Krishna Kirti was also under your coaching. I, when he was a beginner, I used to make him to play the senior player. You have to give him those 21 points game, 18 points, then reducing. The day has come, Krishna Kirti was equal to play with him. With this, Krishna Kirti, down is playing very good. And then he started playing very good against the good players also. For a good player, by down, by up, by taking the by down, he he will be playing with the confidence to reach to the 21 points, to win the game 21 points. This is the whole psychological game. Then handicap, equal players. If you play game and a little bit down player, say give 5 points, that is also develops your psychological game practice. These are the psychological practice in PP2. And coming to the tactical over, then here rest and recovery. Everybody requires, after doing this one for a 1 week, this thing, what you do is, you require rest. Here we are giving the 5% rest. More important given for the physical fitness, and then technical, then tactical, then rest. Coming to the third, that is pre-competitive. In pre-competitive, little bit.
Mr. Mukkamala?
Yeah.
You are able to see the slide clearly?
Little bit, yes.
Are you able to see the slide clearly?
Yeah, yes, now.
We are little running out of time. So
sorry, I'm finishing. In this.
Thank you, sir. No, you cover yourself, but yeah.
In this preparation, you go for the same thing with the matches. And I already told you about this one. Then speed work, stroke practices. In this is the one. And then general training will be there. General, not the meeting, the going for the speed or endurance. General training is there. And then coming back to the game, you know, as for the same stroke practices, different stroke practices. Game practice is there. These things in the, and matches practice, and playing in the state rugby tournaments or anything, not only from the coaching center. And in the coming to the competition period, in competition period, you are giving physical fitness only 20%, because already physically fit, you are already physically fit. Technical, you are giving 20%, because you are already sound in the technical. But here, you have to cube tactical, for that 50%, you are giving more stress on the tactical, because you have to play a number of matches, state and players. You have to play against a good player. How to play? There, here, you require the tactical game. You have to play for the third ball attack, for second ball attack. I'll give you later on the examples. And then, match practice, all the matches. And the coach here has to take very, very important thing, that during the coaching session and during the matches, he has to read closely the weak points and strong points of the player, and he should train as per those things. He should train his training properly. This is over. Now coming to the, as I already said you, psychological rest, that is, this is transitional period. You require the psychological period, that is psychological rest, relaxation. Then biological also, everything is there. Like that, anything you have to maintain, except to leave off general physical fitness. Little bit exercise you will go and leave it. Then in phase 3, phase 4, these things will not that much. Then this is the one transition period, this is the one required. With education, more importance, because annual examination, all these things. Then coming to the next slide, please. Now, I'll share my old experiences. See, earlier, the equipment was not that much good. The halls were not there, and then tables were not good. But our players used to play like in the international level also, though they're not participated much in the international, they play very good. So, example, I can take you on for Vinod Kamlesh Mehta. How he played all these things? By doing all those things, and then he played some of the international events. Though he never concentrated on the table or hall or how the flooring is, ups and downs, no. He concentrated on the match, not even on the player. He concentrated on the ball and then game. Then he won. He made record by winning 8 times. How it is possible? Because of his attitude, his determination, and his positive thinking. All these things made him to become this one. Had he would have got the chance at that time to participate in the more and more international events, though he did in his time good performance in the international level also. Further, you would have improved further in the international level. Here, I would like to say one thing, that is expedite stroke. As you say, that expedite system of the system, the game, but here, expedite of the stroke. Kamlesh plays, whatever the number of strokes he has to play to get a point against any player, he plays that only. Here, because the time is less, I am not going the slide wise, I am telling you the experiences. Here, Kamlesh played with Chetan P. Babur in the Jamshedpur Nationals. In that, Chetan Babur was such a player with the different contact points, sometimes close to table, sometimes in the middle of the distance, sometimes over the table, with which he used to make it used to affect on the rhythm of the opponent. But here, that particular area, I'm telling you, Chetan P. Babur was playing very good. He played as a junior and he has coming up as a senior. He played such a way, he played number of good players. But here, Kamlesh, his determination, concentration, with all those things, he minimized, he studied his game and he brought his strategy and applied his technique by slowing down or making pause. Because I don't know present his weak, his Chetan Babur's footwork, but earlier his body balance was little bit weak because he used to fall down the match itself. I was a witness. But Kamlesh made in such a way, he won 3-2. In the same case here, Kamlesh played against Nupur Santra. Here I am telling you one very important thing. People think that I am very, very good player, I can beat very easily. But here a point comes here. The very, very good player's game suits to the opponent, who has got the lesser standard than the main player. At that time, the strategies comes, the technique acts. Here, Kamlesh versus Nupur Santra is such a match for us in that particular national. I forgot where it has held. Because he has slowed down the player, Nupur Santra, and he brought his effective strokes and 1-3-2. It's a very, very good match. These are the two matches which I cannot forget, and I always used to give as an example of these matches to people. The other one, the present players, they have a lot of facilities. But Sharad Kamal didn't have earlier in his winning stages, these facilities. But with the determination, he started coming up, and recently I saw his match. It's an open international event, played finals. Before that, he won the Petroleum All India Tournament and the National Championship, of course, different ladies. And in the woman, this one is a chevy worked out. And the opponent, Pretol from Portugal, his third ball attack and second ball attack was so good. He lost two games. But as I am telling you here, even today, an Indian player may be weak in the physical fitness compared to the others outside players international level. But my experience as a coach as well as an observer of the top matches, I say that we are better, if not far better, in using the technique and tactical game against any player. Here, Sharad Kamal used the same thing, and here he pushed away his opponent away from the table. Then he brought his forehand and backhand, forward rush, leg cross, body line, and short angles. These are the things in the present conditions. And present players, they are so lucky enough. They have a lot of facilities, number of international events to play. Jose Satyam is a world end player, and say Harmit Deshwai, he also played very good. He got some world end player. these things really, I'm telling you, very encouraging to our junior players. They should see them, they should watch their matches, because the coaches, whenever they go to the nationals, I'm telling you, my own experience, from 8 a.m. to enter into our temple, that is Chabadins Hall, I used to come out for the lunch and then go back, and we used to leave the hall at 8 p.m. or end of the match. Because to watch the matches of the players, my players must have lost, but I watched them, and then I used to explain to their weak points and everything, and I used to make them to play in the practice session. But by watching good players, these things I have learned, the tactical and strategy, I learned a lot from them, really. And then coming to the coaching camp, here I used to interact with the players in the coaching camp, that is SAP Games, held in Pakistan. Or Virat Kamlesh was there, some of the senior players were there, even Raman was there, Sriram was there, and many players, Sujay Kodwada was there, many players like in the women, Sajal Shah was there, and Nyoti Rai was there, and then women national champion, I'm just forgetting his name. They were all there, including that, Namini Kulkarni was also there. Once we had an interaction with the Namini Kulkarni, she said to me, "Sir, I'm losing to our senior players, Vashar Chulani, and Nyoti Rai, Sajal Shah, any other good players. To them, sometimes straight or sometimes K2, something like that. I'm losing." Then I said, "Why you are losing like that?" She said to me that because my height was a little bit shorter, the players are playing short service on my forehand. And by the time I receive and return that ball, by the time coming back, the first drive is to come there on my body or angle or anything. So that is why I'm losing my matches to these players. Once I'm able to convert that one into rally, I was confident to play with them. So for that, what I did is, so on an experimental basis, and I did it, in that I changed her stance from the backhand side, little bit towards forehand side. On backhand only, but little bit forehand side, so that she can reach to receive the short service ball, to return it, and to come back early to the next rally. She made it, she practiced it with the determination. And you know what happened? In the selection tryouts, everybody surprised. She was number one in the selection trials, selected for the SAP Games held in Pakistan. See, interaction between the coach and the player is compulsory, because the players may feel, they may feel that coach may think something. No, the coach has to go down to the age of the children so that they can interact easily. They should feel that he is my father, he is my brother, he is my family member, he is my well-wisher. In this case, I interact in such a way that the trainees, they were not able to tell something to their parents, but they used to tell to me. I used to guide them. This is the way then you can develop the player standard. Coming to my own experience as a coach. Here, we went to Egypt. There, when we went to the practice hall, the team is Haru Basak, Chetanki Babur, Arjun Datta, and Malai Thakkar. The woman, Bhuvaneshwari, Kanchan Dhawan, and then the Archana Rao from Karnataka. This is the team. When we went into the hall, practice hall, our players, they said that to me, said that you may not even win first row. I may be thinking that way, but they told me, I may be thinking, but what I said is, as a coach, if I confirm their idea, their confidence, then they will not be able to win first round. I said, match is different and practice is different. Match is different and practice is different. Here, I said, but as a coach, what I did is, the place that other teams, countries' teams, coaches or LOS coaches, China, Korea, and Japan. What I said, I watched them. The footwork, as Mr. Satyanti had said that, the LRS project is really moving movement with the footwork with the gym. So I watched them and then I found out on their arm movement, their shifting of the body weight, the recovery in the party in the match first round. Aruba Kasak was playing, who has got a lot of control on the ball. He played suddenly in the rally, he played an extreme forehand. The player has played very good forehand from there, and he blocked on the back hand side middle of the table. He could not able to play, but played not that speed. From there onwards, not implement the same tactics continuously. We have played, you know, you believe it or not, our men, our boys and girls team reached the finals. Till that time, not a single press man reached me, contacted me. At that time, they were contacted because of our performance. Here, I tell you again, our players physically may be weak than them. Height point of view also, they are lesser than them. Because our all players, 17 players, maybe international level it is, they are still a junior player. But in India level, they have become the seniors. Immediately we played there, we got these things and Archana Rao case. She played quarterfinals against the best player of the opponent of Egypt. The coach was a well-known player in the international level who was coaching her. And she was down, 2-1 down. Till that time, I was thinking that the opponent forehand is very good. Because she was turning and she played very good forehand. But at that time, here I'm telling you, a team match, we're all one team. The player should come. See, coach may miss sometimes. The player should come, whatever he wants. One point only, he should come and share with the coach to help the player. Arjun Datta came to me, sir, forehand is weak. Then I thought, so what is this, sir? Boy, she played very good, but anyway, we'll see on movement. When we advised her on movement, extreme forehand was very weak. You know, she won 3-2, and in the same finals, because of less time, she lost. These are all my personal opinions. I'll confirm again that our players no way behind any international player till date in the connecting with the technical and tactical. So next, I thank on behalf of our entire Indian sports table tennis family, our beloved minister, sports minister, the way he gave us through his speech with good motivation, the way he has shown interest in table tennis, for the development of table tennis in the country. Really, sir, our entire family is with you. Whatever you do, we are there with you. I may be 12 years old in table tennis, that is 7 plus 5, I am 75, but in table tennis, in our beloved temple, I am only 12 years. I am ready to do, from my side, from our family side, any help, no salary, nothing, I am getting my pension. I don't want to take any amount, I will come and help you. But leaving Hyderabad is a little bit difficult. Give me any program in Hyderabad or other place, I'll do. Till day, I never went off from table tennis. Till day, I'm conducting the state rank tournaments in AP. During that tournaments, I never sat as a chief referee. I used to sit as a coach. I used to reach the all youngsters' performance. I used to interact with them immediately. But here, one thing: when a player, when a coach doesn't know the performance of the player, the playing way of system of the play of a player, coach should not advise in the match. In the practice, he can advise because nothing to lose, he will try, play can try, but not in the match. Example, I can give you, he, Jagannath and me, the nationals, we were interacting with each other. One Indian player from the railway, he came, I think not from railway, came to Mr. Jagannath. Sir, I have to play this match. Please advise me. Mr. Jagannath said that, say, I have not seen your game. How can I advise? If I advise you, it may be wrong. So you will blame me. This is the what I'm telling you. The player should not, the coach should not coach if we not want the player. Then I will thank our beloved Sports Authority of India for giving all the coaches, all the table tennis players in India and Tennis Federation for giving us such a very good chance to interact. And I also thank wholeheartedly the Table Tennis Federation of India, who themselves are taking a lot of interest in improving our beloved table tennis in India. I'm sure with the Table Tennis Federation of India as cooperation, coordination, help, our present internationals definitely will come up in the international level, and one day we can get the Olympic medals and World Championship medals for our everybody's pleasant surprises. What is your pleasure? Very happy we will invite that invitation. Thank you one and all. This old, 12 years old boy says to all our family members for giving me a chance for this to interact with you all. I will thank you once again to all.
Thank you, Mr. Mukamala. That is wonderful. Actually, the topic that you took, I know, I understand that it's a very, very vast topic. It has got a lot of technical things to be done, which may not be actually done in one particular talk. But yes, today we have some limitations. But you have covered it very well. For all the viewers, one thing, the slides that have been put up here will definitely be shared, so that in case you have missed any slides, you can always refer to that. And you can study those slides. Biswajit, may I request you to kindly put on the chat where they can get those slides for references, etc.
And I'll be sharing the slides as of now in the WhatsApp groups, concerned WhatsApp groups. And once our whole program ends, we'll be putting up all the PPTs in a drive and share a downloadable link.
Thank you very much. Because yesterday also we had a lot of requests. So I think it's very clear that all this material that is there is actually to benefit you all. It will be shared and we will inform you where you can get them available. So you can study them, you can refer to them, you can improve upon. If something you have missed out during this session, you can always catch up on this session. Mr. Mukamala, you tried to cover such a vast session in the very short time. It was wonderful effort, I would say. And the one thing that everybody must note that he, as he says, at the young age of 75, where he is having such a lot of spirit, positivity, he's willing to full-fledgedly serve for the game of table tennis, which he loves. It's a fantastic effort. It's a fantastic offer, sir. Your knowledge and experience is very much needed for India to become a stronger table tennis playing nation. And your sacrifice and your passion is well appreciated. And I'm sure that there will be many players who would like to take benefit of your experience. Now, we'll just take a few questions out here. You mentioned the case of Karnam Spurti. You are very closely associated as coach and mentor, etc. with her. Sir, there's a question that like Karnam Spurti, there could be many players who are very talented in table tennis, but they give up for the in preference for education or academics. So what efforts that you did try to convince her from doing so? One, and what is the thing that you can suggest so that in future many of these players who would talented players should not leak out, or you can leave the game?
Yeah. The coach has to take very initiative step here. You should coordinate with the parent. You should coordinate. Say that your boy is playing very good. He can become like this. Here, an example, I can give you one example. That in one of the camp at Nalgonda, of course, I have not, as a coach, I was not participated, but I was invited. I saw SFR Snaith, you may know him. SFR Snaith as a beginner, I'm seeing his approach towards the game. I contacted, his father was there. I interacted with the father. I said, you ship him to Hyderabad so that he can have very good practice and he can become a very good player. But I never told to the secretary of Nalgonda district, otherwise he may abuse me. So he has shifted immediately. There in my training case, Sridhar, he has trained him. Dipesh Singh also trained him. Then later on he gone to Ghosh. There, here, what I'm telling is parental involvement to say that my son should become two nationals, very popular in two nationals. That is most important from the parent side, and the student side, he should always, already he has developed his confidence level by making the schedules in such a way that they never felt very difficult in approaching these two. Same case in the higher level studies also they can do it. They can attend. And as a player, I tell you, one by name is Hanumant Rao. He was in the MBBS at that time. But he played matches at the state level and he performed in the nationals. But here, Kanan Spurthi's case, she has done a lot. But she stayed in the hostel where the facilities are not there to play for table tennis. That may be the reason for leaving. But others, because getting the facilities like previously, they should not leave. Here, one thing I tell you, table tennis will develop overall development of personality with activeness of brain and physical conditions, which is required for everything, which is required. That is, you will become an extrovert personality. Extrovert is important. When you go, everything, every subject, you feel that very easy. I advise the students, they should concentrate more on this, they can continue. Without any, even I choose to tell my students played even when they are in the B also. B final also they played. They represented state. And they never lost any Indian player state. Any of my students.
Another question, sir, is that in morning we have school, so we play only in the evening. So intermediary players, how many hours of session they should have?
Yeah, it's a very important question you asked. My personal experience I'm sharing. In the morning hours, the children have to go by 8:30 by attending to their homework and this and that, and they cannot come. But even then, I used to ask them to do some physical work at home. That is, if I go to half an hour, an available place there. Then some practices at the by 7 o'clock, by 7:30, the parent used to come and stand in my hall. Then by 7:30, I used to relieve them by giving little bit practices, stroke practices, and these things. But in the evening, what they say at 4 o'clock they cannot come because tuition is there. And then I told to parent as well as the players that my duty hours are not 6 to 9, nor 4 to 7. Whenever my student comes, you say wrong, maybe because of the circumstances there, I'm talking. The player, the trainee can come after attending his education, that is homework or tuition. He can come even by 5:36 also. I used to stay up to 9:30 till 10 o'clock.
That is fantastic. That very clearly he has expressed in his talk as well as in his answers that the coach is very important part of training development of a player. And also he also mentioned that the playing facilities during his time, and now there's huge change. Government has done wonderful job. Facilities have come in, rewards, incentives have increased. So it's definitely a very good way to ensure that the players who are in sports can take up sports as a career, and they can definitely be confident with all these various schemes that have been put in place. Sir, thank you very much for such a wonderful session, and your offer that you would like to dedicate entire life to table tennis. You have in fact actually done it, and I'm sure there will be a lot of good learnings for all the players, and there will be a lot of people saying that yes, this is a very vast subject, should be covered more. We'll try to see that how we can do it. But for today, our session ends with this.
My last wish.
Please go ahead.
My last wish is to take my last breath in our temple, table tennis hall, in between our tennis family.
Thank you so much, sir. I am sure all present out here, on behalf of them, I would say that we all pray for you to be healthy, active and sporty in the last breath, and may you live longer, because India needs people like you. to become a bigger powerhouse. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you very much.
With these few words, two, three instructions. So one is the Sports Authority of India is going to conduct a test, online test. The details, the screen is now on the, we'll see the screen on the, we'll see the slide on the screen. Now, yeah, that's the slide, which gives very detailed instructions. The test is for table tennis is going to be on the 30th of May between 10 and 10:30 a.m. The questions will be set by them and it will be NTA, that is National Testing Agency, which will be doing this test. So it's a very valid test and e-certificates will be issued. For Sports Authority of India coaches, it is mandatory to participate in this test and other participants, it is suggested that you do take part. It will give you a lot of knowledge. So please do. And how to register, etc. We will be also informing you and where to register too. Today evening session at 5 will be the sports science session. And it's very important for all the coaches to really get this, listen to this. They are getting wonderful ideas and new trends, but that's very important. And the webinar ID, I would repeat it just once. You all 854-8627-7967.